coming to you from deep inside the bowels of a great big empty. Get ready for another episode of The Home Defense Show with Skip Coriel.
Hello, American families. Welcome to this week's episode of The Home Defense Show. I'm your host, Skip Coriel. And if you love your family, care about them deeply, and want to learn how to protect them in every facet of your life, then you've come to the right place. Oh, we got a great show for you today. We're going to be speaking with Craig Gray. He is a Krav Maga martial arts expert, all about de-escalation, use of deadly force, you name it, this guy knows it. Craig has been on with us before, also on Frontlines of Freedom Radio with us as well. So Craig is going to be talking to us in segments 2 and 3, all about a special event that he has coming on October 17, 18, and 19. It's called the Protector Summit. And you can go right now to theprotectorsummit.com and find out all about that. But Craig's going to be telling us all about that. It is just an awesome, awesome event. Yours truly, i.e. Skip Coriel, was involved in that. And it's just going to be really, really good stuff. And of course, Craig Gray is always fun to talk to, very informative and encouraging. So look forward to that in segments 2 and 3, Craig Gray from theprotectorsummit.com. All right, a little bit of housekeeping here. The Second Amendment March, that's coming up. Whoa, that's coming up on September 10. Folks, that's tomorrow. You got to go to Lansing State Capitol, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We've got all kinds of great speakers there. We've got Maj Tour, the founder of the Black Guns Matter movement. We've got Doug Giles from ClashDaily.com. He's always a special speaker. And then we have got Lieutenant Colonel Denny Gillum, retired Army Ranger, host and creator of Frontlines of Freedom Radio, and my good friend. We've got Sheriff Dar Leaf from Berry County, the 2016 Constitutional Sheriff and Police Officers Association Sheriff of the Year. So he'll be speaking there as well, and many others. Of course, we'll also have about 30 or so vendors there inside the big tent. Man, bring your credit cards, bring cash, because there's going to be all kinds of good stuff there. There's going to be knives, there's going to be ammunition, there's going to be t-shirts and hats and belts and, boy, you name it. And the hot dog vendor is back. I forget the lady's name, but she was the hit last year. Boy, she had, like Polish sausage and bratwurst and hot dogs and lemonade pop, you name it. It's going to be a good time. The weather is supposed to be good. It's supposed to be in the 80s, probably the low 80s for most of the March. So go to 2amarch.com. That's the number 2, the letter A, march.com. 2amarch.com, find out all the details there. It's going to be fantastic. If you miss it, you're going to have to wait another year. So go to 2amarch.com, and I will see you there with all of my books. I'll be speaking as well. So enough said about that. You may have noticed that I am doing a podcast only every other week now. Well, primarily, that's because I've changed my format. You're hearing more about me because I'm doing a video every week and a podcast every other week. So every month I'm doing 4 videos and 2 one-hour podcasts. Why did I do that? Well, hey, it's what you guys wanted. I noticed that when I did a video, I would have 6 times the number of downloads as when I did a podcast. That is very, very significant. So we'll be doing the video, and I'm loving the videos. And my cameraman, Phoenix, my 9-year-old son, he's loving it as well. He looks forward to doing that. This past week, I just did a video on how you can learn and practice that anti-mugging drill where I make 5 headshots in under 2 seconds. Do it safely, folks. Follow the instructions. Do it safely. And then this coming week, we are going to be talking about how to teach your kids how to handle guns. When is the right time? Are all kids different? I'm taking Phoenix, my 9-year-old, to Center Shot Indoor Gun Range in Door, Michigan, where it's always a perfect 70 degrees. And you're going to have some video of him shooting. And I got to tell you, this boy is a natural marksman. So that's coming up in a few days here. Don't forget that. Also, my books, Civilian Combat, the Concealed Carry book, and Concealed Carry for Christians on Amazon.com. But I wanted to talk to you briefly. Folks, I don't like begging for money, all right? I don't like doing that. But this activity, the Home Defense Show, it takes several days a week of my time, doing the videos, doing the podcast, as well as some measure of expense. If you could help me defray my expenses at the very least, just go to homedefenseshow.com, click on podcast, and actually there is a donate button up there on homedefenseshow.com. But when you're into the podcast, there is a green button that says become a patron. If you can click on that and leave me, you know, $1, $2, $5, $10 a month, that would be fantastic. And that will help me defray my cost so that I can keep doing this because I just love it. And I just feel like it's worthwhile to the general public. Enough said about that. Become a patron. Help me out here. All right. Lots of things happening at home here. Right now, even as we speak, I am harvesting staghorn sumac berries. And you're thinking, what the heck's a staghorn sumac berry? Well, it's those little red cones on top of the staghorn sumac sapling. They're shaped like a cone. If you go ahead and take those and rub them between your thumb and forefinger and then taste your finger, you'll notice it's very lemony. We are making staghorn sumac lemonade this week, and we're going to be canning, I don't know how many jars we're going to do, but we're going to do, it's kind of a Native American lemon drink is what it is. Now, please don't confuse staghorn sumac with poison sumac. Totally different stuff. Don't make poison sumac drink, okay? Go online, compare poison sumac to staghorn sumac. Unless you're a future Darwin Award recipient, you're not going to get them mixed up. But hey, that's what we're doing. We're also canning tomato sauce as well today. So, and of course, the firewood is almost all in. And this coming Saturday is the opening day. Saturday and Sunday is the Michigan Youth Deer Hunt. And my 13-year-old son, Cedar, he will be participating. He will be deer hunting for the first time. And boy, I'm excited about that. I told him, I said, Cedar, you're 13 years old. It's time to become a man. It's time to stop shirking off. I need your help filling the freezer, so get your butt out there. And he was more than happy to do that. He took hunter safety. We got him all sighted in yesterday. You know, our good friend Bobby gave him a 20-gauge shotgun, camouflage, Mossberg, telescopic sight. If he misses, it's his own fault. All right. Well, maybe the deer had something to do about it, too. Who knows? But hey, we'll get you some video on that as well, some special video of the youth hunt. And that should be really good stuff. Okay, let's get to the news. There's a lot happening in the news these days. You know, if it seems like there's a mass shooter, and I don't like referring to them as mass shooters, they're really mass killers. Every time I go to the gun range, I'm a mass shooter. Why? Because I'm shooting mass amounts of lead downrange, 300-400 rounds, because I love it and it's fun. Every time you go hunting, you're a mass shooter. All right? But these people are mass killers. They're mass murderers. They're worse than Jack the Ripper, if you studied history at all. So let's start calling them mass killers or mass murderers, because that's really what these folks are. I notice in Texas, Governor Greg Abbott, if I go to bearingarms.com, Greg Abbott, the governor of Texas, just signed 8 executive orders following all of these mass shootings, these mass killings. And, you know, I always get nervous when any politician does anything immediately following one of these mass murders. This is from bearingarms.com by Tom Knighton. Texas has a long and solid reputation as a pro-gun state. After all, if you talk to most people and ask them which state they most think of when it comes to guns, most would undoubtedly think of the Lone Star State, and I am no exception. In truth, well, Arizona's good too, and Utah. In truth, Texas has some less than gun-friendly laws on the books, but they're still fairly pro-gun. That stance feels a little shaky after 2 major mass shootings within the span of a month within the state. Governor Greg Abbott has found himself under enormous pressure by anti-gun forces following the most recent mass shooting in Odessa, Texas. To that end, the governor has just issued 8 executive orders to address what he sees as an information gap that led to the shootings. And here is his pronouncement here from the executive order. Whereas on August 3, 2019, a gunman killed 22 people in El Paso and injured dozens more in a despicable act of domestic terrorism, and whereas the mother of the El Paso gunman had previously expressed concern to police about her son and the weapon with which he would later commit his cowardly act, and whereas on October 31, 2019, another gunman heinously killed 7 people in Odessa and injured dozens more, and whereas the Odessa gunman had called both the police and the FBI prior to his shooting spree, had previously failed a background check, and was recently reported to law enforcement for confronting a neighbor while brandishing a semi-automatic rifle. And you know what? You don't hear about that on the mass media, do you? You just don't. You don't hear about all that stuff. These people were already known to law enforcement and the general public. There just has to be a mechanism for outing these people and confronting them before they start killing all these people. And I think that's what these executive orders are aiming to do. Whereas these tragic events come in the wake of other mass shootings in Texas, including one in which a gunman in Santa Fe opened fire in his high school with a shotgun and a revolver, another in which a gunman murdered worshipers at their church in Sutherland Springs, and another in which a gunman fatally ambushed police officers in Dallas, and whereas mental instability, racial hatred, extremist ideology, a desire to sow domestic terror, and other factors have contributed to these horrific mass shootings in varying degrees, and whereas legislative action has been and will be taken to safeguard against these dangers, and whereas, in addition to further legislative action, executive action can be taken immediately to help prevent more mass shootings and keep Texans safe, and whereas revised and readily available standards for gathering and processing information about potential criminal or terrorist acts can lead to swifter action by law enforcement to prevent such acts, including mass shootings. Now, and here's where he gets to the point. Now, therefore, I, Greg Abbott, governor of the state of Texas, by virtue of the power and authority vested in me by the Constitution and statutes of the state of Texas, do hereby order the following. Order number 1. Within 30 days of this order, the Texas Department of Public Safety shall develop standardized intake questions that can be used by all Texas law enforcement agencies to better identify whether a person calling the agency has information that should be reported to the Texas Suspicious Activity Reporting Network. I didn't know there was a Texas Suspicious Activity Reporting Network, but you know what? I think it's a good idea. When someone calls and says, hey, somebody just, confronted me with a gun, said they were going to kill me. You know, in law enforcement, that's what we call a clue, okay? That's evidence that a crime has been or is about to be committed, okay? So, hey, this Texas Suspicious Activity Reporting Network is a good idea. Order number 2, within 30 days of this order, the Department of Public Safety shall develop clear guidance based on the appropriate legal standard for when and how Texas law enforcement agencies should submit suspicious activity reports. Order number 3, within 60 days of this order, the Texas Commission on Law Enforcement, they're going to make training available to educate all law enforcement officers regarding how these standards should be developed and enforced. Order 4. The DPS will create and conduct an initiative to raise public awareness and understanding of this suspicious activity reports used by law enforcement. Another good idea. Order 5, the Department of Public Safety is going to work with Texas Education Agency and Texas Higher Education Coordinating Board on better ways to inform schools, students, staff, and families about the importance of this activity report network. Order 6, DPS shall work with local law enforcement, mental health professionals, school districts, and others to create multidisciplinary threat assessment teams for each of its regions. Okay, order number 7, DPS, as well as the Office of the Governor, shall use all available resources to increase staff at all fusion centers in Texas for the purpose of better collecting and responding to suspicious activity reports. And order number 8, beginning January 1, 2020, all future grant awards from the Office of the Governor to counties shall require a commitment that the county will report at least 90% of convictions within 7 business days to the Criminal Justice Information System. At the DPS. Apparently that's not happening. Greg Abbott, governor of Texas. you notice those executive orders, they all fall short of something. What is that? They fall short of the police knocking on your door, beating down the door, coming in with a SWAT team, and taking your guns without you even knowing what the heck's going on. Meaning there will be due process. You got to have due process anytime you do that. Granted, we have got to do a better job as a society of finding out who these people are, knowing who the threat is, and the suspicious activity report is a good way to do it, I think. All right. Again, it falls short of violating your Second Amendment rights. If you're reported, you'll be investigated, and then due process will be followed. Of course, all of these things, whether it's legislation, whether it's an executive order, the devil's in the detail and how it's enforced. So I believe, you know, Greg Abbott, not only is he getting pressure from anti-gunners, I'll bet you $1 million, he's getting pressure from pro-gun people as well. So after all, it is Texas. We'll be following that. Would be great if we could get something like that in other states to head off this big, huge political push and pressure for red flag laws. We don't want red flag laws. And these executive orders, in my mind, is something that could be used to stave off red flag laws in the great state of Texas. I see little to no hope of our governor in Michigan doing anything like this. But we'll see what happens. Stay tuned. In the meantime, go to the Second Amendment March, 2amarch.com. We got to see you there. Protect your Second Amendment rights. We're about out of time for this segment in the Home Defense Show. 2-minute break coming up. After that, we'll be speaking with Craig Gray, the creator of the Protector Summit. Go to theprotectorsummit.com. Check that out. We'll be talking to Craig about Krav Maga. We'll be talking to him about martial arts, talking to him about de-escalation and theprotectorsummit.com. While we're away, check out our sponsors, firearmslegal.com/MidwestTactical, and see how Firearms Legal Protection can help you and your family if you ever have to use your gun for personal defense. Also, check out Suarez International. Suarez International, great training, great equipment, match-grade barrels, match triggers, you name it. All kinds of good slides. This is your Red Dot Glock Center, suarezinternational.com. And, of course, check out CenterShot Indoor Gun Range, centershotgunrange.com, where it's always a perfect 70 degrees. This is Skip Corey on the Home Defense Show. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back.
Welcome to the Home Defense Show with my dad, Skip Coriel. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back.
Do you have a story inside you yearning to come out? As a self-published author, you are free to creatively distribute your book online or using your own professional connections. White Feather Press will publish your manuscript and set up online distribution, allowing the author to retain all copyright and distribution rights as well as all profits. Check out White Feather Press at publishyourdream.com. White Feather Press, reaffirming faith in God, family, and country. Go to publishyourdream.com today. Hey folks, I want to tell you about my book, Civilian Combat, the Concealed Carry Book. More and more people across the country are seeing the dangers in society and are deciding to carry concealed to protect themselves and their families. My new book lays it out step by step. It'll teach you how to protect and defend the ones you love. Get the benefit of 19 years of teaching experience and a lifetime of training for this important role in society and in your family. You can get Civilian Combat real easy. Just go to Amazon.com, search on Skip Coriel, Civilian Combat, and it'll pop right up there. Don't put it off any longer. Get Civilian Combat, the Concealed Carry Book by yours truly, Skip Coriel. Hey folks, this is Skip Coriel, host of the Home Defense Show, and I'm here to tell you that owning a gun doesn't make you a gunfighter any more than owning a guitar makes you a rock star. And that's why you need the services of a man who's been on the streets and experienced the ins and outs of real-life gunfights. I'm talking about Gabe Suarez from Suarez International down in Arizona. Gunfighting is a skill set that has to be learned and practiced, and there's no better gunfighter training in the country than Gabe Suarez. Gabe's tactical pistol, rifle, and shotgun classes are all top-notch and have been proven in combat. But you need more than the best training. You'll also need the best gear. Gabe Suarez designs and builds the best combat firearms in the country. Guns like the Glock 17 Gutter Snipe, with its Suarez match-grade barrel, signature flat trigger, and match-grade slide, topped off with a rugged RMR Trigicon sight of your choosing. The Gutter Snipe will make you the best at protecting yourself and your family. So drop what you're doing right now and go to SuarezInternational.com and see how Gabe Suarez can help make you the best gunfighter that you can be. That's S-U-A-R-E-Z International.com. SuarezInternational.com. Would you like to take your tactical and marksmanship training to the next level? If the answer is yes, you need to check out Center Shot Indoor Gun Range just south of Grand Rapids, conveniently located off US 131. Center Shot is one of the most advanced firing ranges in Michigan. Center Shot firing lanes have nearly 100 customizable shooting programs to make you better no matter what your skill level. Our advanced lanes allow a more immersive training experience to enhance your senses. Controlled lighting and target movement mean that you get the best practice and most fun out of Center Shot Indoor Gun Range. Memberships are available for as low as $150. Center Shot also offers a 10% discount to U.S. military veterans. So, no matter what the weather, hot, cold, or in between, Center Shot Indoor Gun Range is always a perfect 70 degrees. This is where I train every week, and so should you. Find out more by going to CenterShotGunRange.com or call them at 616-371-7468. Stay safe, and I'll see you at Center Shot Indoor Gun Range.
This is Colonel Danny Gillum. I host Frontlines of Freedom, a weekly syndicated military talk radio show. One of my co-hosts is Skip Coriel, the host of this show. We cover things that impact military and veteran communities, and we do it from the veteran's perspective. The show is broadcast across the nation and is also available as a podcast on our website, frontlinesoffreedom.com. Please join Skip and me weekly on Frontlines of Freedom.
Well, okay, folks, welcome back to the Home Defense Show. There's your host, Skip Coriel. Today we are speaking with one of my best martial arts, deadly, open hand guy, Craig Gray. And you, Craig, you've got just all kinds of stuff going on, and I know you have a special place in your heart for military veterans. But before we launch into this special event that you have going, please tell us a little bit about yourself, Craig Gray. What kind of things do you got going?
Well, Skip, first off, thanks so much for having me on your show. I really appreciate it. Glad to talk to all the folks out there, and appreciate your time. So a little bit about my background. When it comes to my main job and function in life nowadays is to teach people how to be better protectors, how to be what I call peace walkers, which means, a little deceptive maybe, it means, yes, to have peace within yourself and to try to perpetuate that outside, but also, you know, if you have to defend yourself in any of the modalities, so to speak, that you're able to do that. So you're skilled at the art of conflict management, both inside of yourself and around yourself. My journey in that actually started in the martial arts when I was a young man. My dad was a Marine, and he studied martial arts when he was over in Okinawa and the Philippines. And then when he came home and had me back in the late 60s, early 70s, he introduced me to it.
Mm-hmm. Well, so I like him already. He's a Marine.
Right.
And he's in the martial arts, and he is your dad. So keep going.
Yeah, so basically, as I kind of traversed that, being a martial artist and then, and, you know, did the usual, went to school, went to college, got out of college, and so forth. I started teaching martial arts when I was quite young, and it quickly developed into an interest in security and mm-hmm. security services and this type of thing. So I was teaching a lot of police officers because at that point in time, this is back in the, you know, like the 80s and 90s, before they had a lot of real cohesion in their training after the academy. So basically, the guys that I started to teach, they would come to me and say, hey, this is kind of what happened to me last night. What would you do? And so I started showing them, and eventually it kind of caught on because they would try it and it would work. And then next thing you know, they'd be asking me more questions. So before you know it, I'm doing ride-alongs with police officers, and I'm getting hired by different police departments and all this. This is back before Rodney King and that type of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, if you guys out there remember that, it's more than a couple minutes ago nowadays. It doesn't seem like that long ago, but it ended up being. But anyway, so I did a stint in, I started doing serving papers and doing security type work. I eventually got into being a bodyguard, into executive protection. So a lot of my field work is in that. And I started working with a lot of more police officers and military personnel. This started off being very physical as far as the hand-to-hand combatives and that type of thing, because I had an expertise in martial arts and then field experience in real life. And then eventually what had happened is I realized that to really mitigate conflict, the physical nature of it is one thing, but there's a lot more to it than just learning how to kick and punch and that type of thing when it comes to real world altercations. You know, life really isn't like an action movie, although in our heads it often plays out that way, you know, in our fantasies. But so what I started to realize and help people with is I started modeling kind of best practices of both what worked for me to mitigate and to diminish conflict and to handle it, and also what I experienced when I started working with police officers and military and schools and hospitals and even some organization stuff such as like Mel Trotter Ministries and DTE Energy and this type of thing. So I've been hired by Fortune 500 companies, trained with a lot of organizations ranging from military and law enforcement and, like I said, hospitals and schools and whatnot.
Yeah.
So that's kind of, I know it's kind of a mouthful there, so I didn't bore your listeners too much, but that is really what I do nowadays. I don't do security myself so much anymore. I don't do many executive protection details any longer, but I'm still very active in martial arts, and my main job now is to go out and teach individuals and organizations how to manage conflict more effectively and how to develop what I call a protector's lifestyle, because that's very much it. It's a transition of perspective a lot and developing the skills and tools to be able to handle conflict more effectively, which is, and you know, you teach defensive firearms tactics, Skip, and you know what it takes when you get these folks in to learn how to use that tool for the right purposes of defending life, is more than just taking a class.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. This is Skip Coriel on Home Defense Show. We're speaking with Craig Gray from the Protector Summit. Now, Craig, you know, when I'm listening to you talk here, actually almost every time I listen to you talk, I get the impression that one of the main goals, maybe it's the primary goal of all of this training, is so that, you know, basically, you know, I'm going to talk to you. I'm going to be real nice, flowing speech. I'm going to try and de-escalate you. You know, otherwise I'm going to have to kill you and or hurt you or something like that. Is that pretty much the mindset or not?
It is, but let me clarify it even further. The primary, the foundation of everything that I teach is to protect life,
mm-hmm.
and to show respect to the value of the human life. Now, as we know, sometimes when we're dealing with conflict with another individual, that other individual may not reciprocate that same respect.
Right.
Right? So that is when things become a little bit more complicated.
Yeah.
So how do you both, and this is a little counterintuitive, but how do you respect the value of life and appropriately deal with behavior that might be disrespectful, it might be dangerous, and it could be even deadly?
Yeah.
So that's the kind of the paradox that we're working with of how do I do that? How do I separate in my head that respect for life, but yet dealing appropriately with behavior?
Yeah.
And you need to be very clear on that. And you also have to have a lot of tools So understanding how to keep your emotional stability, your baseline, we call it, keep a cool head about you, be able to maneuver physically, be able to verbally communicate and influence, and if push comes to shove, and if necessary, that you can physically engage as well to do most good, least harm for everybody.
Yeah.
Now, most good, least harm is a little confusing too, because it's not most good, no harm. Sometimes, as you know, sometimes people need to be detained, they need to be disciplined, sometimes they need to be hurt, and sometimes they even need to be taken out of the equation, taking a life, but it is only because that's a last resort and it's a force continuum. Does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely. It's like, tough love on steroids, when you have to take it to that level. But, when you look at society now, I don't know. There's always been that element of society, a small element that wants to dominate their fellow brothers and sisters. And
sure,
they have to be, not necessarily controlled, but like if you've ever done any canning, a pressure cooker has got that little thing on top that jiggles and relieves a little bit of stress. It's like there are parts of society that are always on a low boil, ready to explode or boil over, and it's difficult to deal with people like that, without the skills, the verbal skills, to de-escalate, the nonverbal skills, and then if push comes to shove, sometimes talking is enough, and you have to be able to back it up with physical skills, with a totally different skill set. But I like the way you approach it, Craig. You do a great job. You communicate it very, very well. I had a question on your early martial arts career. Did you start out with Krav Maga, or did you start out with something else?
I started with something else, and just to kind of qualify Krav Maga to those folks out there maybe who are listening who don't know what Krav Maga is. Krav Maga means contact combat, and it is the official defensive tactics system of the Israeli Defense Force. It's gained a little bit of momentum here in the United States, but that is a tactical system, although we treat it in the United States more like a martial art. But to answer your question, Skip, no, my dad started me in boxing, and he started me in Okinawan karate.
Oh, okay.
And then I went out after his influence. I started, I had and have quite an interest in martial arts, so I achieved black belt in a number of different systems that were traditional martial arts and sport martial arts. I did point sparring when I was a kid, and then I went to full contact kickboxing, and then submission grappling in an MMA when I was a little bit younger, back when it was kind of first starting and getting going. I trained, we were like the first MMA place and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu place in this area back before it was really popular.
Mm-hmm.
But traditional martial arts too, Kung Fu, I did a form called a Pinjak Silat, which is an Indonesian system. Got a black belt in Taekwondo, Bujinkan, Taijitsu, which is a Japanese, traditional Japanese style. I have licenses for that. And obviously Krav Maga, which is Israeli methodology. So I could go on, but I don't want to go too much. But you get the idea. I am steeped in traditional martial arts, sport martial arts, and tactical martial arts.
Okay.
And I think the difference being that when I was first introduced to Krav Maga, it was in the mid-90s, probably early mid-90s. And I remember it was some Marine again. Marines keep rearing their heads up here.
Mm-hmm.
But I was out at an executive protection school getting some certifications, and they had just gotten off from deployment from out in Israel, and they're like, hey, have you ever seen this? You're into martial arts. Have you ever seen this Krav Maga stuff? And I'm like, well, yeah, I've heard about it, but thought it was just showing me some things, and I really got enthused about it because it was very simplistic. Mm-hmm. It was very real-world applicable, which all sport and traditional martial arts are not. So Krav Maga is kind of learn today, use tonight kind of a approach,
yeah.
Where a traditional martial art and even sport martial art can be, learn it today and hopefully use it sometime in the maybe near future, but maybe not.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. Well, hey, Craig, we're about out of time for this segment. But when we come back, I want to talk to you about your Protector Summit. I personally am very excited about that. I think it's an awesome, awesome endeavor that you're undertaking here. And I want you to tell us all about it in the second segment. So we're going to go ahead. We're going to take a 2-minute break here. Everyone, while we're away, go ahead and check out our sponsors, farmslegal.com/Midwest Tactical, and then check out Centershot Indoor Gun Range, centershotgunrange.com, where it's always a perfect 70 degrees, and then Suarez International out of Phoenix, Arizona. All right, when we come back, again with Craig Gray and the Protector Summit. This is Skip Coriel and Home Defense Show. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back.
Out on the Home Defense Show. Always use guns safely and wisely. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Hey folks, this is Skip Coriel, host of the Home Defense Show, and I'm here to tell you that owning a gun doesn't make you a gunfighter any more than owning a guitar makes you a rock star. And that's why you need the services of a man who's been on the streets and experienced the ins and outs of real-life gunfights. I'm talking about Gabe Suarez from Suarez International down in Arizona. Gunfighting is a skill set that has to be learned and practiced, and there's no better gunfighter training in the country than Gabe Suarez. Gabe's tactical pistol, rifle, and shotgun classes are all top-notch and have been proven in combat. But you need more than the best training. You'll also need the best gear. Gabe Suarez designs and builds the best combat firearms in the country. Guns like the Glock 17 Gutter Snipe, with its Suarez match-grade barrel, signature flat trigger, and match-grade slide, topped off with a rugged RMR Trigicon sight of your choosing. The Gutter Snipe will make you the best at protecting yourself and your family. So drop what you're doing right now and go to SuarezInternational.com and see how Gabe Suarez can help make you the best gunfighter that you can be. That's SuarezInternational.com. SuarezInternational.com.
Wouldn't it be wonderful if life was like the movies and the good guys always won? In today's world, if you're forced to use your firearm to protect yourself, you will need protection. Firearms Legal Protection is here for you. FLP provides you with seasoned, experienced attorneys that handle your criminal and civil matters as a result of you protecting yourself. FirearmsLegal.com provides its members with uncapped attorney's fees, bail bond protection, and coverage in all 50 states. We are not a reimbursement plan. You can access uncapped attorney's fees for as low as $10 a month. Firearms Legal members are provided with educational services, training videos, and access to our vast national attorney network. While you're protecting yourself, let Firearms Legal protect you.
Listen up, folks. This is important. There are plenty of legal protection services out there, but none will protect you as well as Firearms Legal Protection. This is the one I use and the only one I recommend. Visit firearmslegal.com/Midwest Tactical and protect your family now. Would you like to take your tactical and marksmanship training to the next level? If the answer is yes, you need to check out Center Shot Indoor Gun Range just south of Grand Rapids, conveniently located off US 131. CenterShot is one of the most advanced firing ranges in Michigan. CenterShot firing lanes have nearly 100 customizable shooting programs to make you better no matter what your skill level. Our advanced lanes allow a more immersive training experience to enhance your senses. Controlled lighting and target movement mean that you get the best practice and most fun out of CenterShot Indoor Gun Range. Memberships are available for as low as $150. CenterShot also offers a 10% discount to U.S. military veterans. So, no matter what the weather, hot, cold, or in between, CenterShot Indoor Gun Range is always a perfect 70 degrees. This is where I train every week, and so should you. Find out more by going to CenterShotGunRange.com or call them at 616-371-7468. Stay safe, and I'll see you at CenterShot Indoor Gun Range. Hey folks, I want to tell you about my new book, Concealed Carry for Christians. More and more people across the country are seeing the dangers in society and are deciding to carry concealed to protect themselves and your family, and that includes people of faith. Our churches are not as safe as they used to be, and that's why I included chapters on forming church safety teams and stopping mass shooters. You can get Concealed Carry for Christians real easy. Just go to Amazon.com, search on Skip Coriel, Concealed Carry for Christians, and it'll pop right up there. Don't put it off any longer. Get Concealed Carry for Christians by yours truly, Skip Coriel.
Okay, folks, welcome back to the Home Defense Show. This is your host, Skip Coriel. We are speaking today with Craig Gray, Krav Maga, Master Yoda of the Protectors Summit. Actually, you don't really look that much like Yoda, but do you ever use the Force, Craig?
Well, you know, the Force is stronger in some than others. We'll just kind of leave it at that.
Okay, all right, Craig. Before we launch into the Protector Summit, I'm going to tell you a short story. This is Skip Coriel's martial arts story. Right, I've been into your dojo several times, and very, very impressed with Krav Maga, you know, as a tactical fighting skill. And, I signed up for one of your classes, I was very serious about doing it. And then 7 days before it started, I hurt my back. And so then I said, well, I got to put this off for a while. And so I put it off while I was healing. And then I get ready to do it again. And then my 12-year-old son comes to me and he says, Dad, I want to take Taekwondo. And I said, well, why? He said, well, because all my friends are doing it and, it looks cool, so I want to do that. And I said, okay, well, I think you can do that. And then my 9-year-old, Phoenix, he comes to me and says, well, Dad, Cedar's going to do it. I want to do it too. Okay, yeah, fine. You can do it too.
I want to do it too.
Yeah. And so, but then they go, well, Dad, you should take it with us. And I go, guys, I'm 61 years old. Well, I'm only 9, okay? So in order to be a good dad, I had to take Taekwondo. And so, we all three signed up for that, and that was like in April, I think we did that. And so the first, session comes up there, and of course everyone lines up according to rank. And guess where the white belts are? They're like all the way in the back of the class. It's like you can barely see the instructor. And I'm used to being the instructor. So for me, it was a little bit of humble pie. I get in there, and I'm a white belt, and I'm all the way in the back. And I look around, and for like two or three rows all around me, all I see are, they're either children or dwarfs. I wasn't sure. Everyone's like half my size. And so I felt like, all right, this is really, really humbling. I'm like 61 years old and I'm just starting, with these 5-year-olds. And, I got to tell you, we've been doing it since April. We just tested a few weeks ago for our yellow belt and, nice. we all passed. And I am getting some useful stuff out of it. One, it's keeping me active. I mean, it keeps me humble, keeps me active. I just like being around other people with that warrior mindset. So, I just wanted to tell you that story, a little bit comical, entertaining. But now, Craig, I want you to tell us about your Protector Summit, because I'm all excited about that. What's that all about?
Well, I appreciate you asking, Skip. And I will let it be known out there as well that Skip Coriel is one of our speakers. So what I decided to do about a year ago, I thought to myself, I work with so many interesting military guys that they have a lot to offer. They have a lot to offer people who are looking to learn how to be better protectors, learn how to develop a protector's lifestyle, and also maybe reach out to some of their compadres, their veteran friends who maybe are having a difficult time transitioning or have been in the civilian world for a long time and maybe got disconnected somehow with their identity as a protector. Mm-hmm. So I thought, I could interview all these different hard chargers that I know and ask them three questions. So we had three discussion points, and the three are, the first one was, if you had to recommend how to defend yourself better, defend your family better and community better, if you had suggestions on what the most important things to do that, what would that be from your experience? So you get to hear from Navy SEALs, you get to hear from Israeli Force soldiers and counterterrorism experts, you get to hear from Green Berets, a lot of the guys that I've had the pleasure and privilege to do work with, train and do conferences with and do trainings with and teach with, are some of the best that we have in our country in regards to security experts and this type of thing. And they're all vets.
Yeah.
So I went out and I decided to ask them that question, because I think a lot of folks who maybe aren't or have not been in the military and aren't maybe a first responder or anything, they want to know how to protect themselves better. They want to have the peace of mind to know how to protect their families better and live in a community that has less violence. And these guys have a lot of resources to talk to and talk about that. So that was one of the questions. And the other two questions revolve a little bit more around the vet community. And the second question was, if you had a friend who was a vet who was struggling with their identity, what advice would you give them when they went from a soldier to a civilian in regards specifically to their identity as a protector? What advice would you give them? And then we talked about that a little bit to see, because I know there's a lot of guys and gals coming out of the service now and maybe who've been out for a while who just, you know, maybe they were clear about this idea of being a protector in the military, but as they transitioned into civilian life, they didn't know how that applied anymore.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So rather than hearing it from me or hearing it from some psychologist, why don't you hear it from the guys? Because everybody who I talked to, yourself included, had a, I wouldn't say they had an easy transition necessarily, but all the folks have transitioned well, and they're doing great things with their lives to be protectors and to teach this idea of being a protector. And they have a lot of insights, boots on the ground, on what they did and what they saw and how they dealt with it. So we talked about that. And then the final question that I think is plaguing the United States right now is, do you see a gap between the military and vet community and civilians? And if so, what are some things that we can do, not talking about policies, not talking about laws? Obviously, there's a lot of laws and policies that could be changed to help with this, but I'm talking boots on the ground, face-to-face, person-to-person. How can we close that gap, both vet to civilian as well as civilian to vet? And what suggestions that some of these guys, yourself included, had maybe to help with that circumstance? And I'll tell you, Skip, the insights that I got from these guys, yourself included, was amazing. And many of the things that you folks said, I think will surprise a lot of people on what insights that you had to share. And the other interesting thing is these weren't just American soldiers from the U.S. military. I also have the opportunity to work with a lot of Israeli soldiers and Israeli veterans. So I also had the opportunity to interview those guys. So not only are you going to hear from Marines and, you know, Navy SEALs and Army Special Forces, Green Berets, but you're also going to hear from our colleagues and friends from Israel, from the Israeli Defense Force, and guys who have been out there and done it and are still doing it and teaching other people how to be protectors as well.
Yeah, it's got to be different over there. I've never been to Israel. It's on my bucket list. But, you know, it's got to be different over there because it must be like living on the south side of Chicago every single day because, and it's a generational thing. It's like it's been going on for decades and decades and decades. So, how is it different over there, Craig?
Well, I've been to Israel a number of times. I go every year or so. And when it comes to the military, as you know, it's a conscription army, so everybody's got to be in the military.
Mm-hmm.
The men have to do, I think, 3 years full-time, and then they have to, it's mandatory reserve duty until you're like 40 or 42.
Wow.
So everybody's been touched by the military, and then the females have to do some type of public service. And they have to do 2 years of some civic duty. And many of the women are choosing to go in the military as well. So, you know, in the United States, where you got maybe 2% of our population that's been in the military, I mean, in Israel, you literally probably have 90% or 80% of the people that have been in the military.
Yeah.
With men, anyways. With women's probably less, but still, they're directly connected. And, So there's not as much of a gap in those communities. And Israel's very small. It's about the size of New Jersey. And so military service over there is a bit different. But also, as you pointed out, too, the south side of Chicago, so to speak, analogy is, you know, they live under constant threat from their enemies. They are surrounded by enemies. So they have I think all the citizens that I've run into and met with and I'm friends with and have relationships with, they are way more security-minded.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Much more so than we are here in the United States. And here, it's very compartmentalized. You know, you've got your police officers, and they should do police officer stuff, and you're in the military, and they should do military stuff. And I'm a civilian, and I don't want to deal with all that other stuff. And I know that's a big part of your home defense show is kind of bringing that mindset, that protector mindset to the masses, so to speak, to, hey, we are all protectors on the inside. We just have to dial things in to make sure we're protecting the right things in the right way.
Mm-hmm.
So the Protector Summit is really about that. So it's a free summit that's online that you'll be able to hear from about 25 or so vets that I interviewed. And you can register online. It's going to be a live online experience. So it is October 17th, 18th, and 19th. Of this year, and I'm going to MC the interviews, so I'll talk a little bit about the person that's going to be on the interview, and then I play the interview itself, and then I'll kind of introduce the next one. So each of these guys I have a story with, so I tell a little bit about our background, our stories, and the kind of what projects they're doing and so forth, and then I play the interview, and you get to hear from these guys themselves on what those discussion questions were.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if you want to learn how to build a protector's lifestyle, be a better protector, protect yourself better, protect your family better, protect your community better, and hopefully you're not having any struggles as a vet, but if you are a vet and you're struggling with your identity, or you want to connect with guys who see and have transitioned that protector identity into their civilian life, this is the summit for you.
Yeah. Yeah, it sounds just awesome, Craig. That's October 17, 18, and 19. What is the website where people can go to register?
Theprotectorsummit.com.
Got it. Theprotectorsummit.com, October 17, 18, and 19. And you must go on and pre-register, and it costs nothing. Is that correct?
It is free for the live summit. There are some options if the individual wants for kind of like a VIP access if they want some other goodies. But the summit itself is absolutely free. All you have to do is register so we can send you the private link to the broadcast.
Yeah. You know, we talk about, you know, a possible potential gap between civilians and military veterans. You know, it is there. And one of the challenges that I have for my military friends, my military vets, is some of them, especially the combat vets, a lot of the combat vets, it's like they go there, They do their job. They do things that they, you know, wouldn't have chosen to do out of a sense of duty or whatever. And then they come home, and then they don't talk about it. They maybe compartmentalize it, put it away, and say, okay, that's in the past. I don't have to think about that anymore. You know, I encourage those guys, you know, go ahead, bring it to the forefront. Deal with it. Sort it all out so that you can continue to be a protector and defender in your civilian life. Sure, the rules of engagement are different. It's different scenarios. But the skill set and the mindset that you learned in the military is incredibly vital now in our American culture. So I think this would be great for military vets and civilians. So, Craig, I'm really glad that you're doing it, and I was honored to be a part of it, and just, you know, to be alongside, you know, these other greats. I saw some of the names that you have on there, and they're just awesome, awesome guys, and I personally can't wait to hear all these interviews. I'm definitely going to do it, and I will help spread the word. That is theprotectorsummit.com, October 17, 18, and 19. Go online and register for that right now. Craig, if someone's interested in Krav Maga or any of the other things that you do, how can people find out more and contact Craig Gray?
Well, if you go to that website, theprotectorsummit.com, you will find, being that I created it and I'm part of it, but you can find my information through that resource.
Awesome, awesome. That's theprotectorsummit.com, October 17, 18, and 19. And the longest journey begins with a single step, and the warrior lifestyle is a long, long journey. And this could be your first single step to getting into that protector lifestyle. So, Craig Gray, I want to thank you very much for doing this, and thank you for being on the Home Defense Show today.
Thanks, Skip. I appreciate you having me on, and I appreciate your work on the summit and you being involved with that. And obviously, I do thank you and all the vets out there for their service to this country.
Awesome. All right. That's Craig Gray from theprotectorsummit.com. Check that out, October 17, 18, and 19. We're out of time for this segment. We got a two-minute break coming up. While we're away, as always, check out our sponsors, firearmslegal.com/Midwest Tactical, and also Suarez International out of Phoenix, Arizona, and, of course, Center Shot Indoor Gun Range, centershotgunrange.com, where it's always a perfect 70 degrees. This is Skip Coriel on Home Defense Show. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back.
Welcome to my dad's Home Defense Radio Show. You're gonna love it.
Hey folks, I want to tell you about my book, Civilian Combat, the Concealed Carry Book. More and more people across the country are seeing the dangers in society and are deciding to carry concealed to protect themselves and their families. My new book lays it out step by step. It'll teach you how to protect and defend the ones you love. Get the benefit of 19 years of teaching experience and a lifetime of training for this important role in society and in your family. You can get Civilian Combat real easy. Just go to Amazon.com, search on Skip Coriel, Civilian Combat, and it'll pop right up there. Don't put it off any longer. Get Civilian Combat, the Concealed Carry Book, by yours truly, Skip Coriel.
This is Colonel Danny Gillum. I host Frontlines of Freedom, a weekly syndicated military talk radio show. One of my co-hosts is Skip Coriel, the host of this show. We cover things that impact military and veteran communities, and we do it from the veteran's perspective. The show is broadcast across the nation and is also available as a podcast on our website, frontlinesoffreedom.com. Please join Skip and me weekly on Frontlines of Freedom. Skip, it's time for our Armed America Report. What do you have this week?
All of us here at Frontlines of Freedom want our listeners to get trained and get armed in that order. We fully support the right to keep and bear arms for all law-abiding families, and we encourage you to find out about the laws governing use of deadly force in your state and follow them to the letter. And of course, don't forget to follow the rules of safety and common sense whenever you're carrying a firearm to protect the ones you love. What's the story this week, Colonel?
An intruder wielding a machete tried to break into a DeKalb County, Georgia neighborhood home at 5:30 a.m. one day. Police found broken windows and glass from two doors that the intruder had smashed to gain entrance into the home. Inside the home, the intruder was confronted by the homeowner, who fired two gunshots a few seconds apart. The intruder was shot in the chest and later transported to a local hospital, where he was pronounced dead. An investigation was launched as the police tried to identify the intruder.
Thanks, Colonel. Bladed weapon attacks are on the rise in the U.S. as well as around the world, especially in industrialized nations. According to Wikipedia, a machete is defined as follows. A machete is a broad blade used either as an implement like an axe or in combat like a short sword. The blade is typically 12.8 to 17.7 inches long and usually about a tenth of an inch thick. In the Spanish language, the word is a diminutive form of the word macho, which was used to refer to sledgehammers. In various tropical and subtropical countries, the machete is very common. It is the tool of choice for agricultural use, but is also the weapon of choice by criminals. It is also carried often by law-abiding citizens as a self-defense tool, since their governments have largely banned the ownership of firearms. Due in part to the influx of legal aliens pouring in through our southern border, America has seen a rise in machete and other bladed weapon attacks. Usually, a gun can prevail over the machete, provided the potential victim is not caught off guard and they have proper training, marksmanship, and warrior mindset. When attacked by a machete, two tactical responses are paramount. 1. Keep your distance. The gun has the advantage because of its longer reach, but machetes have the advantage at close range and will kill you just like a firearm. 2. Put an obstacle, such as a car, a table, or even a shopping cart, between you and the machete. This will give you time to draw and put bullets on target. As the number of illegal aliens pour across our border from third world countries, you can expect machete attacks to continue to increase. America is usually behind Europe in these trends. England, for example, who openly welcomes illegal immigrants, has seen an 80% increase in bladed weapons attacks since 2014, according to a report from the BBC. Frontlines of Freedom recommends you get out ahead of this trend by getting trained and armed in that order. This is one case where you want to avoid the cutting edge. This particular Georgia homeowner did a great job defending his life and his home with excellent marksmanship. Frontlines of Freedom salutes his spirit.
We sure do.
Hey folks, I want to tell you about my new book, Concealed Carry for Christians. More and more people across the country are seeing the dangers in society and are deciding to carry concealed to protect themselves and your family, and that includes people of faith. Our churches are not as safe as they used to be, and that's why I included chapters on forming church safety teams and stopping mass shooters. You can get Concealed Carry for Christians real easy. Just go to Amazon.com, search on Skip Coriel, Concealed Carry for Christians, and it'll pop right up there. Don't put it off any longer. Get Concealed Carry for Christians by yours truly, Skip Coriel. Okay, folks, welcome back to the Home Defense Show. This is your host, Skip Coriel. Craig Gray, one of my favorite martial arts guys. You know, whenever I talk to Craig, you know, and a lot of these, you know, people that we would call operator types, right? And I would put Craig in that category as well. The guy's highly, highly skilled in open-handed skills. And, you know, I suspect he can handle a firearm as well. But, you know, they always seem so calm, you know, so relaxed. And it's like they're just in total control of themselves, right? And it's like they'll be talking, yes, yes, my name is Craig Gray. You know, it's kind of like, you know, remember Kung Fu, David Carradine, way back in like the late 60s, I think, early 70s. You know, David Carradine, you know, Grasshopper, Kwai Chang Kane, he would always talk that way. I have no wish to fight you. You know, and, oh, please, please don't push me. Please stop slapping my face. I am peaceful. You know, and the whole reason we were watching that show is because we knew the bad guy out in the Old West was going to push him too far. And then, you know, Kwai Chang Kane was just going to let loose and just say, okay, enough's enough. Time to kick your butt. You know, when I think of Craig Gray, I always think of that. I always think of Kwai Chang Kang. I have no wish to hurt you. But you know, you know, there's like 57 different ways that he can snap your neck and reach down in and rip your heart out, you know. So, but fortunately, he's a nice guy and he doesn't want to do that. He has no wish to hurt me. You got to check out theprotectorsummit.com. October 17, 18, and 19, theprotectorsummit.com. Go online there. Register for that event. It's all online. You can visit it anytime you want to. There's no excuse for not having time to do this because, hey, it's your time. You can choose when you go to do that because it's online. All right. Again, I want you to also check out 2amarch.com, the number 2, the letter A, march.com, 2amarch.com. And you need to be there September 10. That's tomorrow, guys. If you miss it tomorrow, you're going to have to wait another whole year, and I won't feel sorry for you. But it's a great event. It's a great time. I'm going to be there. If you're there, come to the big tent, right? Come to the big tent. I've got my book signing table there. Would love to talk to you. Also, check out our training, Midwest Tactical Training, MWTAC.com, Michael Whiskey Tango Alpha Charlie.com. We've got advanced classes in October. All through this winter, we're going to be teaching the Level 1 Advanced class at Center Shot Indoor Gun Range. So I'll be posting those as well. If you want to get involved in that, just send me an email, skipcoriel@hotmail.com, skipcoriel@hotmail.com. If you want to complain about me, if you want to call me dirty, nasty names, skipcoriel@hotmail.com, skipcoriel@hotmail.com, and I will properly take care of that email. All right. Well, okay, folks, it's been a great show. Great time with Craig Gray. We got all kinds of wonderful things coming up. This weekend, I'm going to be out there hunting with my son, and it's going to be fantastic. You'll hear more about that and more videos coming up as well. Well, okay, folks, that about wraps it up for this week's episode of the Home Defense Show. Until next week, remember, your purpose in life is to find something greater than yourself and serve it. Always remember, God, family, country, in that order. It's important how you live, but it's equally important how you die. Your family and the ones you love need protection, so train, always train, stay alert, stay alive. Until next week on the Home Defense Show, this is your host, Skip Coriel. God bless you, God bless your family, and God bless America. And God bless Craig Gray, theprotectorsummit.com. Check it out. See you next week.
Thank you for joining us this week on The Home Defense Show. Now, get out there and protect the ones you love. We'll see you next week with more of the best in home defense.
Bye-bye, boys!
Have fun storming the castle!